When Mississippi native Lance Bass rocketed to fame with the group NSYNC, he made his home state proud. He was inducted into the Mississippi Musicians Hall of Fame, a small town boy made good.
Every time I come home, I was a hero. My family was treated, you know, so great.
But Bass says that adulation turned to scorn in 2006 after he revealed a long-held secret. He was gay.
The state rejected me once I just came out, and one little issue, and, you know, all that was just taken away.
Bass tells Showbiz Tonight he got death threats, and his family back in Mississippi was heaped with abuse.
Every day of people making comments to them, saying they want to kill me, you know, patting them on the back, saying, I'm so sorry, like I had died.
In the new documentary, Mississippi I Am, the singer recalls the pain of that time.
Radio attacked me, and I was even wiped out of ad campaigns for Mississippi.
Everyone just kind of wanted to forget that I ever existed.
Bass executive produced the film, but he's not its main subject. The primary focus is on gay teens in Mississippi who share their own struggle with coming out in a very conservative state.
If you're different in any way, they kind of turn their back on you.
The documentary includes interviews with anti-gay Mississippians and audio from a Tupelo radio station.
My God, your God, our Lord and Savior would not make someone a homosexual. This is a dangerous behavior. It is killing children.
We all forget that it's so easy to be in New York, LA, Chicago, Miami, places where it's just really easy to be yourself and be gay and everyone accepts you. We forget about the small town USA.
I met up with Bass at the Redberry Hotel in Los Angeles, seemingly a world away from his hometown. He remembered his feeling of desperation as a child when he became aware of his sexuality.
And I knew I was gay at 5 years old. Like, I knew it. I knew I was gay. I knew what it was.
That
I knew,
young.
Oh, at five. So you tell me it's a choice. I knew at 5 years old, but I knew I had to hide it from everyone.
Out of fear or shame?
Both. Shame and fear. Yeah, I just knew it wasn't right. I knew it was wrong, that something was wrong with me. So every single day, I pray to God that he would change me to be straight. Every single night, I would cry and be like, please, let me wake up tomorrow and be straight. And I hear that from so many kids.
Kids like Jesse and Audrey, who appear in the documentary. They're among a growing number of young gay people in Mississippi who embrace their sexuality. Audrey is part of the Mississippi Safe Schools Coalition, a group formed by gay kids and their allies, which puts on an alternative prom. Bass returned to Mississippi in 2010 to support the event.
About 400 kids came from all over the state. I got chill bumps thinking about it.
What have they taught you?
I've learned so much from these kids. I gave up on my state. I will admit it. I completely gave up. I would definitely go back home and visit my family, but it was a place where I just didn't think anything was ever going to change. Everyone was so hard-headed, just like myself, and you're not going to change people's minds. But these kids taught me that at any age, you can change people's minds.
The documentary Mississippi I Am may change some minds as well, Bass says, even among his closest relatives.
My family's very right-wing, conservative, religious. They are the people that we want to see this film. And for their reaction to be like, this is one of the most beautiful things that we've seen, they learned a lot of things. That's the reaction I definitely wanted.